Here's a couple of tips to think about and to remember when you're talking with people and being people with one-on-one that may be useful when we talk to a bigger group. So if you're talking fast and a lot, that communicates a sense that you're nervous, that you're in a rush, that you don't actually want to be there. I've seen this in presentations a lot. When students get up and they give a presentation, think about oral argument, think about a hearing before a judge, they speed read. They try to get out from behind the lectern or the podium as quickly as possible because it's clear that they're petrified and they don't want to be there. As an audience member, that makes you uncomfortable. So think about this and the idea of when you're talking fast and a lot, you're communicating things that maybe you don't want to communicate. On the other hand, if you're talking slow and not so much, that communicates a sense of calm, that you're in control. And it satisfies what I think is the ultimate test when it comes to public speaking. So you want to read the ultimate test, Mr. Patel?
People pay attention even when you aren't saying anything.
And that's why I picked the photo of Brian Stevenson when he's not actually saying something. So we talk a lot about this idea of charisma, that charisma is when you hang on someone's every word. I think that's actually incomplete. I don't think it's the case that charisma is only you hang on someone's every word. I think real charisma, charisma of someone like Brian Stevenson, is that you hang on every pause. You get someone like Brian Stevenson, he comes in, and even when he takes a pause, people are rapt. People are paying attention. So you want to achieve that level of charisma by building in these pauses. Another way to think about it is not that charisma is something that's spontaneous, but this, Ms. Giles.
Voice can be planned.
It can definitely be planned. So we want to try and build in these moments to have some pauses and have some poise.